Friends, welcome to our channel Mechanical Motivator. Now we are going to see a problem on section of solid on a topic which I am going to teach is a tetrahedron. In previous problem, we just saw when we cut a tetrahedron, we just get a square, right? In this problem, we will be getting a triangle. So these two sums are very very important. In exam point of view, in case if you are twisting the paper, means they might ask such type of questions. So initially I will be explaining the question, then given data, and I will be telling how to draw the diagram. A tetrahedron of base side 60 mm is resting on HP. So they clearly said that a tetrahedron will be resting on HP. Tetrahedron will be of four sides, and tetrahedron means we will be drawing a triangle. So triangle is the base diagram. If the four sides of the enclosed the triangle, means we will be getting a tetrahedron. So base they clearly gave us 60 mm, okay, and it's resting on HP. Resting on HP means we will be drawing the triangle on HP. On its faces, it is cut by a plane perpendicular to VP. So if it's cut by a plane perpendicular to VP, means it's inclined to HP. So we will be cutting the plane inclined to HP, but they haven't given any particular angle. But instead, they have gave another idea or clue. That is, so that the two shape of the section will be triangle. So whatever shape, true shape which we are going to get will be a triangle. For the triangle, the base would be 40 mm and height would be 30 mm. So this is the hint. But they didn't give any detail regarding the cutting plane. But what I am telling is, when we cut the tetrahedron in such a way that we will be getting the true shape as a triangle, base as 40 and height as 30. Locate the cutting plane and we have to draw the sectional top view and true shape of the section. The first step is we will be drawing the reference line, and according to first line equation we will be writing VP above and HP below. It is clearly given that the tetrahedron, the triangle is the shape, true shape of the diagram. We can see the true shape only from the top view, and also they also give an intense resting on HP. So we can draw the triangle on HP. So height, so see here the side is 60 mm. So this side is 60 mm. Take your compass, keep your compass here and cut an arc, and keep your compass here and cut an arc, so that you can get a third point. So ABC will be a triangle and all the sides are equal. Next thing is we need to fix the center. For fixing the center, we need to join this corner bisecting this line. We need to join this corner bisecting this line. When we join this corner bisecting this line and this corner bisecting line, we can easily get the center. So here we will be drawing the axis for the front view. After that, we have to join the slant edges like OA, OB and OC. Now we will be drawing the front view. For drawing the front view, try to extend this line. If you extend this line vertically, means we can easily get a point. That BA point can be, we can get here. If you use your scale here and keep your scale here, we can easily get a point for C. For axis also same. Where we get the O point, in straight line we need to get the axis. So see here, the axis height is not 40, okay, axis is not 60. Actually, the side of the tetrahedron is 60, right? So what we have to do is, you have to take 60 mm. Just draw this axis for a particular distance. Actually, we need to draw this axis for a particular distance, and we need to have measure 60 mm, and just take your compass, measure 60 mm, keep your compass there and try to cut an arc on the axis. So where it ends, keep that point as O dash. So O dash B dash would be 60 mm. It's not axis. O dash B dash is 60 mm, and finally you can join with C dash. Now we have drawn the front view, and here is the top view. Next thing is we need to draw cutting plane. For cutting plane, what hint they gave is that is the true shape would be a triangle, and the triangle would be having a base of 40 mm and height of 30 mm. So we need to get your true shape as the triangle, or sectional top view as the triangle. So for triangle, the base is 40 mm, right? See here, you have to keep your scale here. So total height will be 60. Try to move the scale parallelly. You have to move the scale parallelly. The point which you get here will be 40. Okay. So just see here, or else do one thing. So total will be 60, means just take 1 centimeter or 10 mm. Okay. So total length of this triangle will be 60 mm. Just leave 10 mm at the top and 10 mm at the bottom. So that try to move the scale, you can easily get the point. There are two ways to draw this line. One thing is from A, you leave 10 mm, 1 centimeter, you keep a point here. From B, you leave 10 mm, from bottom to top, you can keep a point here. So just keep your scale and try to move, means you can easily get the point on OB. That point is called 2 and this point is called 1. What I am going to tell is that the length of 1 and 2 is 40 mm. So this is the base of the triangle. This base should be 40 mm. Try to keep your scale. You have to extend this line. See here, 1 and 2 you got point right. Keep your scale and try to extend your scale in vertically. It will be cutting the O dash B dash. when it bad it cuts, keep a point. See, you can see 2 but you can't see 1. That's why I write as 2 dash bracket 1 dash. Okay, we need to keep a point here. What we are doing is we are just extending 1 and 2 vertically upwards. So automatically we will be cutting the O dash B dash at that point. We will be naming it as 2 dash and 1 dash. Now take your compass. Now take your compass. We need to measure the altitude is 30 mm, right? Take your compass, measure 30 mm. Keep your compass here and try to cut an arc on O dash C dash. Where you are getting, that will be 30 mm. So altitude is 30 mm. Take your compass, measure 30 mm. Keep your compass here and try to cut an arc on O dash C dash. So that point will be called as the second cutting point. Automatically we will be getting one cutting point because O dash C dash is the one edge. So here we will be getting one cutting point. When you cut a point, you will be getting one cutting point. So O dash C dash is the third cutting point. Now try to extend this point vertically. 3 dash is being O dash C dash, right? So with O and C, we will be getting third cutting point. So this is called the sectional top view. 1, 2 you already got, third point you just now got. So if you join all the points, you will be getting a triangle. So if you just join the triangle, this is called the sectional top view. And you have to ask this length, hatching is 45 degree. And all the lines should be having equal spacing. Whatever you are drawn here, you will be getting a 2 shape here. Try to draw here, another new reference plane parallel to the cutting plane. And you will be just representing the sectional top view as the 2 shape of the section. Now we will be drawing another new reference line which must be parallel to the cutting plane as we saw in previous all diagrams itself. Same procedure you need to repeat. Now you have to measure from here. So here we will be having a vertical line, right? So it will be cutting here. So just take your compass, keep your compass at the old reference line, measure the distance between how much distance from here to 1. The same distance you will be having here. Measure from reference line to 2, how much ever distance you are getting. For same distance you will be getting here. I just drawn it approximately. When you draw exact, your diagram would be in a different shape. You can also refer the PDF which I share with you. Next thing is, just measure from the old reference line till this point, third point. The same distance you will be getting 3. So if you join 1, 2, 3 means, you just hatch it up. Here we will be getting a true shape of the section. Whatever sectional top view we are getting, here we will be getting a true shape of the section, and this one is called the sectional top view. The height of the text should be 10 mm and the heading is section of tetrahedron. And last but not least, you need to write the rightmost bottom corner. All dimensions are in mm, scale 1 is to 1, height of the text should be 5 mm. If you feel this video is useful, then you can share with your friends and do subscribe my channel. Then only you can get the regular videos which I upload for engineering graphics. And thanks for watching this video. Have a great day.